Right, so I apologise for the audio. My my camera and my microphone are all at my other work, so I don't have them tonight. So tonight I'm going to be painting, and again, I can't see if you can see this, but there's a, we went down to Bulli, which is down south of Sydney on the weekend, and it was just blowing an absolute gale. And as you can still hear, the weather is still pretty bad outside. So this is what I'm going to be painting tonight. We'll see how we go doing that. And so I'm just using my iPhone tonight, so we'll see how that goes. So I'm going to do the sky first, and I've just put some tape down on here. And it's this tape, I normally use 3M magic tape, but this is tape I just got from Woolworths from the shopping centre the other day. So I hope it comes off without tearing the paper. We'll see how that goes. So I'm just going to do the sky first, and that'll just involve me wetting the page. So I'll just do that. Just wet the page. Normally I use a spray bottle, but I don't really want to spray water everywhere. I want to be a little bit more controlled and just bring it up. And by the way, in case you probably can realise this, but I always paint in standing. I was thinking about this the other day, like it's good painting in standing, especially when you start painting larger sizes, allows you to move your body, allows you to do totally different strokes than you would do if you were sitting. So no matter what size you paint at, I would suggest that you paint in standing, if you can. If your body doesn't allow you to do that, then sit and stand. But if your body can, then by all means, I would say stand. It allows you to do more vigorous, energetic marks. I have no idea what that sound is from outside the wall of this studio. I've never heard it before. Kind of sounds like a tree creaking or something, but I've never heard it before. Alright, so I'm just going to dry this now. Removable tape. Oh, my last bit. Is it long enough? Because this is a removable tape, I can press down as hard as I want on this, and I really need to press down hard because otherwise it definitely will not do its job, and it still might not do its job. It just depends on how it behaves. think that's probably enough. For those who like really, really finished pieces, then I could do a line of white all the way along here. It wouldn't be realistic, but it would probably be, for some people, very visually pleasing to have that line. But I quite like this, just the way it is. If you're going to do scratching back like this, it's really important that you dry the paper enough. I probably could have dried this a little bit more, hence why coming away in sort of bigger chunks, but it's fine as long as you know what the rules of nature are, really. So thanks for joining me in this one tonight of Bulli down south, down near Wollongong. It was a pretty amazing windy day, and hopefully this captures that. So thanks for joining me. I'll see you in another one. Good night.